Inside the White House by Ronald Kessler. This book bears a dedication for Pam, Rachel, and Greg. Acknowledgements. Having probed two powerful secretive institutions, the FBI and CIA, I was looking for another challenge. I found it in the White House. Even though the White House and its occupants appear on television almost daily, what really goes on in the White House rarely comes out. Indeed, I found that, fearful of the consequences of talking, the people who surround the President and First Family, the Secret Service agents, maids and butlers, Air Force One stewards, and the chefs and ushers, are actually more secretive than CIA and FBI officials who have access to classified information. Luckily, I began the book with good sources. As a Washington Post reporter, I had probed the mysteries of the White House's finances and had developed some critical contacts. I had also reported on the General Services Administration, which maintains the east and west wings of the White House, and had long-time sources there. Most important, when I had finished my book on the FBI, FBI agents introduced me to Secret Service agents who knew practically everything about what goes on behind the scenes at the White House. While they cannot be named, I am grateful to those sources, without whom this book could not have been written. My editor, Paul D. McCarthy, senior editor at Pocket Books, is as much responsible for this book as I am. He not only immediately recognized the idea as worthwhile, but also came up with an organizational structure that made all the difference. He then applied his awesome talents to editing the manuscript, giving it greater clarity and depth. My agent, Robert Gottlieb, executive vice president of the William Morris Agency, supported the project strongly and was a source of wisdom. My wife, Pamela Kessler, a former Washington Post reporter who is the author of a book on Washington's spy sites, initially edited the manuscript and shared her exceptionally good judgment with me. I am fortunate to have her as my colleague, friend, and wife. My children, Rachel Kessler Engelhart, now a Washington reporter, and Greg Kessler, a New York artist, were sources of pride and support. My friend Daniel Clements read the manuscript and offered helpful insights, as did several other friends who cannot be named. Those who were interviewed or who helped in other ways include Ralph Albertazzi, Raleigh D. Amix, Toinette Toy Beshelder, William M. Baker, William P. Barr, Robert E. Barrett, Paul W. Bateman, William J. Bell, Shirley Bender, John V. Jack Brennan, Jimmy R. Bull, Stephen B. Bull, James A. Buzzelli, William J. Joe Chappelle, Daniel M. Clements, Clement E. Conger, Kenneth L. Cox, John Cronin, Jr., James U. Cross, William F. Cuff, Lloyd N. Cutler, John W. Dean, III, Jan Duplain, Mary Ann A. Esperancilla, Fred F. Fielding, Marlon Fitzwater, Jennifer Flowers, Gerald Ford, Ron Geisler, and Stanley J. Goodwin. C. Boyden Gray, Shirley Green, Bill Gully, Sean T. Haddon, W. Robert Bob Hall, Henry Haller, Robert T. Hartman, George Herzog, William J. Hopkins, Lou Hubbard, Frank A. Hughes, Joseph A. Jaworski, James R. Jones, Representative Paul E. Kanjorski, David Hume Kennerly, Kenneth L. Kachigian, Laura Copelson, James F. Kuhn, Joseph Layton, Louis J. Lawrence, Robert A. Lazaro, Donald F. McCown, Lester C. McClelland, Robert M. McMillan, Ed Mencken, Morton Mintz, J. Bonnie Newman, D. Patrick O'Donnell, Terence O'Donnell.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.